Business Central Telemetry Triage Errors Using a Power BI Report. Business Central emits telemetry data for various activities and operations on tenants and extensions. Monitoring telemetry gives you insight into activities and the health of your tenants, so you can diagnose problems and analyze operations that affect performance. This video shows how to use a standard Power BI report to analyze errors using telemetry. The report is available from the Business Central Telemetry Samples GitHub repository. We'll download the report, get an application ID from Azure Application Insights, and then we'll explore the error report in Power BI Desktop. Prerequisites for using the report is to have enabled telemetry on one or more Business Central environments or extensions, and access to the Azure Applications Insight resource that stores the data. We'll also need Power BI Desktop. Let's start by downloading the reports. We'll open a browser and type aka.ms/bctelemetrysamples to open the BC Tech repository. Now we'll choose the Power BI directory, then Reports, and then Error Report. To download the report, we'll choose Download. We'll open the report to start configuring it. We need an application ID from the Azure Application Insights resource that stores the telemetry data. We need the key so that we can read data from Azure Application Insights. On the Application Insights page in the Azure portal, under Configure on the navigation pane, we'll choose API Access and then use the Copy to Clipboard action to copy the application ID. We'll paste the Application Azure Insights application ID in the App ID field, and then define the period of time we want to analyze by specifying start and end dates. We can also add an AAD tenant ID and an environment name as additional filters. Especially for extension telemetry, sometimes it's useful to leave these fields blank if we have enabled Azure Application Insights for multiple environments. If we have a lot of data and just want to experiment, we might consider using the top parameter to limit the number of rows that each data source in the report will fetch from Azure Application Insights. When we choose Load, the report will refresh with data. This can take a few minutes depending on the amount of data we have. Authentication from Power BI to Application Insights only works if both resources belong to the same AAD tenant ID, the organizational account. Okay, here's our report. Let's start with the README tab. There are two things that are especially important to notice. First, there's guidance on the difference between the Power BI report and the Jupyter notebooks for troubleshooting. Second, depending on our version of Business Central, we might not have data for every tab in the report. There's a link to the Signal Overview page where we can find out when different types of signals were added to Business Central. The README Error Types tab shows the telemetry event IDs to look for if we want to dig deeper into a particular topic using the Cousteau query language. For example, if we want to analyze an issue with login errors, we can filter on the RT0001 and RT0002 event IDs in our Cousteau queries. Now let's explore some error data. We won't cover all of the tabs in the report in this video, just highlight some of the frequent situations that we might need to troubleshoot. We can use the Authorization tab to figure out why a user can't sign in. There could be multiple reasons for that. For example, maybe the user doesn't have a valid license, or maybe the user is not enabled. The Authorization Errors tab shows us when and why sign-ins fail. The Email Errors tab helps us keep emails flowing for our customers. For example, if a customer is experiencing that emails are not being sent from Business Central, we can identify when the failure happened and which email connector was used. We can use the Extension Lifecycle Errors tab to analyze problems compiling, installing, or updating extensions. This part of the error report is especially useful for ISVs because it provides a quick overview of all errors that happen with your app across all your Business Central environments. If we call web service endpoints in Business Central, we can use the Incoming Web Service Errors tab to analyze requests that did not return an HTTP status code in the 200 range. The tab shows which endpoints are failing and the category of the endpoint, such as API, SOAP, or OData. Let's move on to the Job Queue Errors tab. We can always monitor failed Job Queue jobs on the Business Central client, but what if we want to see failures across multiple environments? or data outside the retention policy period of the job queue log. On the Job Queue Errors tab, we can analyze job queue failures and filter by environment, code unit, or object type. Using the Outgoing Web Service Errors tab, we can go deeper into errors that happen in services we connect to from Business Central. We can go from an endpoint to a code unit behind it, or from a code unit to the endpoints that use it. If the endpoint is owned by a third party, we can use the report to highlight stability issues in their service when contacting the third party's support organization. Finally, we have the Report Errors tab. In this video, we don't have any data to show, and that's actually a good thing because the report shows situations where a commit statement was issued in a report that was canceled by a user or by the Business Central server. If we had data here, we might have an issue because not all code in the report was run after the commit statement. Our documentation has details about this situation, so go to the README Error Types tab to learn more about error types. And that's it, at least for now. To learn more about Power BI reports based on telemetry in Azure Applications Insights, visit aka.ms/bctelemetrysamples. You'll find links to sample reports and additional information about how to connect Power BI to telemetry in Azure Application Insights. If you're interested in learning more about Business Central and telemetry, this playlist offers several other videos on the subject. There's one that shows how to get started with Application Insights, another about analyzing performance using a standard Power BI report, which is much like what we saw in this video, one that shows how to write custom queries in Kusto, and one about troubleshooting using Jupyter Notebook guides. Thanks for watching.